Now so let's go
yeah,
back.
Yeah, let's go back to Simulation Data Inspector, right?
Yeah. So we ran the simulation a couple times already. One time we use manual, but this time we use automatic PID. So mm-hmm. I'll rename the automatic PID tuning as just a reference for my sake.
Yep.
And I'll compare my baseline using this compare tab, my baseline as the starting point. And I'm going to compare it with the automatic PID tuning that I have done.
Okay.
I can compare these two simulation runs, and it would visually show me how the signals are different and the difference between the values of the signal at the bottom half.
Okay. So for here, it's showing you that, you know, clearly we had different response signals between the starting point of 555 and then mm-hmm. the automatic. And it's telling you the difference is about 0.9. And
right.
You could set a tolerance
right.
when you're doing these differences. So by default, it's just zero, mm-hmm. which is why you're getting that X over there on the left, because it's out of tolerance.
Right.
So I guess for this example, you know, we expected the results to change.
Yeah.
So, you know, obviously we're going to be out of tolerance. But I think one of the reasons why people use this comparison tool is, you know, let's say you have a model, you want to, look at changing some parameters to maybe optimize the performance, but you don't want the actual results
right.
To change.
Right.
And you just want to make sure that the changes that you make don't significantly change the desired response.
Yeah.
You can do this comparison in here and make sure that everything is staying within
fine.
Tolerance. Right?
Yeah, exactly. And these fields are editable. So
yeah.
you can, if you want
so if you
strict
change that
tolerance,
to say one.
If I change it to one, this should turn back to and like run compare again.
Mm-hmm.
This should turn green because our difference is only 0.94.
Right.
So
okay.
That's what it is. Like sometimes you just want the output to be same, like Michael just mentioned, and that in that case is you could set a tolerance and check for the results.
Yeah, and you can imagine your model, and this is only two signals, right?
Yes.
Most likely you're going to be interested in more than two signals
yeah.
in your own models, and it'll just track all of those comparisons here in one spot.
In one spot, yeah.
Yeah.
And in addition, you can also send these results to MATLAB Figures.
Oh, so if you click on that, it'll just open up a MATLAB figure?
Yeah. And I can try doing that. And that would be a MATLAB figure. Here you can basically add additional information like titles and so on.
Sure.
And I don't know. I mean, you can do additional data manipulations right here.
It's nice being able to go from this tool to MATLAB Figure because a lot of people are used to working with MATLAB Figures.
Exactly.
So,
yeah.
You know, whatever you're comfortable with.
Yeah. Instead of pulling the simulation data and then plotting it on your by yourself, writing
mm-hmm.
code and doing that, you can automatically create figures from here.
So what if you do want to store all this data, though? It's
yes.
pretty easy to do that, I think.
Yeah. So you can save this data right from the menu items here. And oops, it's just creating multiple windows because it's loading, I guess. And so I can create comparison data mat file. It's stored as a mat file.
Mm-hmm.
And as you can see, this now becomes a mat file, which is being represented within Simulation Data Inspector. So when I close MATLAB, come back tomorrow, and want to continue with my analysis, I can simply load that mat file using the Simulation Data Inspector,
yeah.
and then I'll be able to compare those.
Yeah, and what's nice, it also showed the same views
yep.
That you were looking at before. So it'll open it up in the exact spot
yep.
That you're in the last time. So you could literally continue from where you left off.
Exactly. So that's the benefit of Simulation Data Inspector. It goes one step beyond visualizing. It helps you compare and do additional analysis right from the UI itself.